Keeping up with technology is hard. There's too much information to keep track of. It's time for a simple and straightforward approach. It's time for IT Insights.
We're seeing a lot of great traction in the market for HPE ProLiant for Microsoft Azure Stack. What I wanted to do today is talk with Claude Lawrenson about what is Azure Stack, how is it different from Azure, and what traction are you seeing in the market?
That's great. Well, Azure Stack is essentially an extension of Azure on your data centers. It uses the same API, the same portal, the same billing system as Azure, but it brings a set of IaaS and PaaS services from Azure in your own data center. It's a very elegant concept. It brings the cloud to your on-premises environment for scenarios that are needed where, for example, you have latency issues or regulation issues. And the traction has been very, very good. So we're very happy with the momentum we're having. We're having lots of success at first with service providers, and now we're seeing more and more enterprise adopting, and we're starting to win very big deals for Azure Stack.
So when I talk to customers, the conversation always drives towards use cases. So Claude, from a Microsoft perspective, what are some of the key use cases that you guys position Azure Stack for?
That's a really good question. And that's one of the drivers, of course, for the product. So the use cases we've seen are really divided in three areas. The edge and disconnected scenarios are sometimes called the submarine scenario. So think of aggregating data locally and later using Azure for further processing. So this is a scenario very popular in manufacturing. Think of oil and gas. Think of a manufacturing line where there's latency issue and you cannot be connected to the cloud all the time. So Azure Stack provide a very good solution for that. We also see a bunch of usage in areas where you have regulation. For example, this is a scenario very popular in the banking industry, in local government, in healthcare. So if you need data locally that cannot cross a border because your data by regulation has to be in country, or you have to be on premises for some regulatory issue that's quite prevalent, for example, in banking and healthcare, Azure Stack provide the cloud application on your own premises. So that's another scenario that we see, and it's quite popular, like I said, in banking, government, and healthcare. The third scenario is modernizing your application for a legacy investment. For example, if you have a lot of application running on a mainframe and you want to start modernizing with modern PaaS and IaaS services, Azure Stack provide the gap where you can start developing your application. And when you're ready to go, you have the freedom to deploy them either in the cloud, the public cloud, or on-premises, if that makes sense. So Azure Stack is being used in that scenario quite a lot. We see that in a lot of pharmaceutical companies. In general, the scenarios will fit within one of these three big buckets. And now that we've expanded the geography where Azure Stack is available to over 80-some countries, I'm sure we're going to start seeing very different use cases because of remote location and things like that. But essentially, the three use cases I've talked about are the main one.
Okay, great. And I know, too, from an Internet of Things perspective, we're hearing a lot of use cases coming from customers around that as well.
And that's a big driver of future product capacity and capability and product features for Azure Stack.
Okay. Now, I know you mentioned traction a little bit. Can you talk a little bit more about the types of customers you're seeing adopting Azure Stack?
Yeah. So we're really happy with the momentum we're seeing with Azure Stack. We're doing very well with HPE. At the beginning, when we went to market, many of the adopters were service providers because we had a lot of program to help them be early adopters. There was a huge spike of demand from service provider. And now the main drivers is actually enterprises. Is enterprise that are using Azure. They're seeing Azure Stack as a way to extend their use of Azure in use case that they can't use the public cloud. And we're gaining big deal, which really helps the credibility of the product, and it helps generate more mouth-to-mouth demand for Azure Stack. We're, the first year has been very, very good for us. The product capabilities, the geos that we're serving, and the strength we're having with HPE, for example, in many of the verticals, is really boding well for the future. It's something that we're very, very bullish about.
That's great. Okay, great. Thanks for joining me today, Clive.
Thank you.
Appreciate
it. It was great.
Thank you.